Hi friends, today let us discuss open circuit and short circuit tests. The topics to be discussed are significance of open circuit and short circuit tests, open circuit test, short circuit test, calculations of efficiency and voltage regulation. Again, in open circuit test and short circuit tests, there are three subtopics. Those are circuit diagram, procedure, and calculations. And first, the significance of open circuit test and short circuit test. Why we are going to conduct these two tests? These tests are used to calculate equivalent circuit parameters. We have already discussed equivalent circuit of the transformer in transformer 4 topic, where we have so many parameters. In those parameters, shunt branch parameters are there. Those are RC and XM from left side. By these parameters can be calculated by using OC test. And coming to series parameters, RE and XE, these two parameters can be calculated by short circuit test. So this is the advantage of OC and SC tests. So equivalent circuit parameters can be calculated by conducting these two tests. And coming to efficiency at in different loads and power factors can be calculated by using OC and SC tests. So this efficiency has been discussed in transformer 5 topic video. And coming to voltage regulation, at different power factors can be calculated, and that voltage regulation has already been discussed in transformer 6 video. So now let us going to discuss what open circuit test is. So the main purpose of conducting open circuit test and short circuit test are equivalent circuit parameters, efficiency, and voltage regulation. This is the open circuit test. We will conduct open circuit test on LV side. That means the HV side is open circuited and all parameters are connected to LV side. The experiment is very easy. Simply, the coming to circuit diagram, voltage AC voltage source is there, and after this auto transformer is there to provide the necessary voltage only. And then voltmeter is there to know what is the amount of voltage we are going to provide the circuit. And then MLCV, the wattmeter is there. Wattmeter calculates the power in this entire experiment. And A is the ammeter. These all meters are connected in the LV side, and HV side is kept open circuited. And this is the equivalent circuit. Finally, we will obtain. Obviously, we know that primary current I1 is divided into two components. One is exciting current IE and second one is I1 dash. But here, secondary is open circuited. So, I1 dash is the load component of primary current. As secondary is open circuited, there is no current in secondary side, that is I2 equal to 0. And as we know that, I1 dash is just because of I2, so I1 dash is also equal to 0. So we can say that I1 is exactly equal to IE, exciting current IE. Now the exciting current is divided into two parts. One is IC, core loss component of current. Second one is IM, magnetizing component of current. Obviously, IC is flowing through RC and IM is flowing through XM. So based on this is the equivalent circuit for this experiment, and based on this equivalent circuit we can get the equations. Now let us move on to procedure for OC test. How to conduct open circuit test? Here HV side is open circuited, as we have discussed. The rated voltage is applied to the primary by the auto transformer. In this experiment, rated voltage is applied. And what we are going to do is the ammeter records the no load current or the exciting current IE. Next, coming to the wattmeter records the core loss of the transformer. As the exciting current is very less, the copper loss is negligible. basically these tests, we are not going to get anything by these tests. That means all our power is wasted. So whatever amount of power we are providing to these tests, either QC test or SC test, the entire power is lost. So because of that, entire power is lost, and basically the power is divided into two parts, core loss and copper loss. Here the current is very very less, so we can neglect copper loss here. So whatever the power we are obtaining by the wattmeter, the entire power is represents only the core loss. So that's the thing here. Simply we have connected 3 meters, so we need to measure all those readings, and once we have taken the readings, then we can proceed further. And these are the calculations for OC test. I have divided into two parts. One is parameters obtained from the test and parameters obtained from the calculation. So by using this test, the applied voltage, we have already applied the rated voltage, so we know that what is rated voltage. And exciting current we will measure by using ammeter, and core loss of this entire experiment, and that of course core loss of the transformer only, and that will be obtained by reading of the wattmeter. So these, by conducting this test, we can get all these parameters simply by the experiment. So what can we do with these parameters? We can calculate no load power factor cos theta 0, which is equal to PC by V1IE, as PC is core loss, which is equal to V1IE cos theta 0. So we can calculate the no load power factor as cos theta 0 is equal to PC by V1IE. Simple. Next, coming to core loss component of the current and magnetizing component of the current. Core loss component of the current, IC is equal to IE cos theta 0, IM is equal to IE sin theta 0. Now what is core loss resistance? Core loss resistance, RC, is equal to V1 divided by IC. As these two are the parallel branches, the voltage across these two branches is equal, and that is exactly equal to the voltage applied. So obviously RC is equal to V1 by IC. V1 is equal to IE cos theta 0, which is exactly equal to V1 square by PC. Coming to magnetizing reactance, which is equal to XM is equal to V1 by IM. See, by using the same formula, maybe you can use Ohm's law, V1 by IE sin theta 0. So these are the calculations for OC test. So simply I have divided into two parts, parameters obtained from the test and what can we do with those parameters. So this is the explanation for OC test. Let us move on to short circuit test. Under the same headings, we will discuss short circuit test also. First, circuit diagram, procedure and calculations for short circuit test. Yes, this is the circuit diagram of short circuit test. Short circuit test is conducted on LV side, so all parameters are connected on HV side. Here also same thing, voltage source is there and auto transformer is there to provide the necessary current here, and that will be discussed in the procedure. And as here current is important, so I need to keep ammeter just immediately after the auto transformer, and then my wattmeter is there and voltmeter is connected in this fashion. And coming to equivalent circuit diagram, R1 and X1 are primary current, primary resistance and primary reactance. Similarly, R2, X2 are the secondary resistance and secondary reactances, and RC, XM are the shunt branch parameters. But here the current passing through this shunt branch IE is very less, obviously approximately 0. Why? Because here the we are short circuiting the secondary, so use current is passing in that way. That means here, as we know, I1 is divided into two parts, I1 dash and IE. As I1 dash is very high value, as this is secondary short circuited, so I can say that I1 is approximately equal to I1 dash and IE will be neglected. As IE will be neglected, there is no question of shunt branch, and we can remove the shunt branch completely. Once shunt branch is removed, the finally RE, the R1 and R2 can be combined, and that will be called RE, effective resistance. Even X1 and X2 are combined, and that will be called XE, effective reactance. And the current passing through this will be ISC, short circuit current. So this is the explanation for circuit diagram. And coming to procedure, obviously, as we know, LV side is short circuited here, and the rated current is allowed to flow through the circuit. So by using auto transformer, we will set up the rated current in the primary. So we need to move the auto transformer such that your ammeter shows the rated current in this short circuit test. And the voltage records will be the short circuit voltage VSC, and the wattmeter records the copper loss of the transformer, that is PSC. As the short circuit voltage is very less, the core loss is negligible. So same explanation comes here also. The entire power is wasted here also. As the entire power is wasted, so the whatever power is flowing in the circuit will be power loss only, and obviously the lost power may be divided into two parts, core loss and copper loss. But here the current is very high, and the exciting current IE is very less, so we can neglect core loss component. So the entire loss component will be given as copper loss only. So this is the thing for, this is the significance of SC test. Here we can get the copper loss. And coming to calculations, as we know, we are using three meters. One is for voltage, second one is for current, and third one is for power. I can get the obtained from the test VSC, ISC and PSC. By using these three parameters, I can find out leakage impedance referred to HV side, and that will be ZE is equal to VSC by ISC. And then equivalent resistance referred to HV side can be calculated. RE is equal to PSC by ISC square. So this formula comes from copper loss case, which is PSC is equal to ISC square into RE, just like I square R loss. So this is the copper loss. Next, coming to equivalent leakage reactance referred to HV side, and that will be XE is equal to square root of ZE square minus RE square. Obviously the impedance is the vector addition of resistance and the reactance. So based on that equation, we can calculate the leakage reactance of the transformer. So these are the calculations for SC test. So now we know how to conduct OC test, how to conduct SC test, and how to get the circuit parameters, equivalent circuit parameters from OC test and SC test also. Now we need to move on to efficiency and the voltage regulation. Let us see the calculations of efficiency and voltage regulations. So efficiency can be calculated. Efficiency eta is equal to extents of KVA rating into power factor PF divided by extents of KVA rating into power factor plus PC plus X square PCU, where PC is copper loss. Okay, let's move on right from the beginning, where X is the fraction of the load, PF is the power factor. Fraction of the load, for example, I want to calculate efficiency at half load, then my X value is 1 by 2. If I like to calculate efficiency at 3/4 load, my X value will be 3 by 4. Likewise, Like that, we can easily calculate the efficiency for different loading conditions also. So actually we are not loading anything, but still we can get the efficiency for different loadings. And KVA is the KVA rating of the transformer that will be available on the transformer itself. That comes under nameplate readings of nameplate values of the transformer, maybe the ratings of the transformer. PF is the power factor, at what power factor you are going to calculate the efficiency. So as we discussed earlier, efficiency can be calculated at different power factors at different loading conditions. So this is the advantage of these tests. We are practically don't load the transformer here, but still we are getting the efficiency for various loads and for the various power factors. So this is explanation for what we have discussed in the maybe second or third slide. Coming to voltage regulation, V2 minus V2 is equal to I2 RE2 cos theta 2 minus I2 XE2 sin theta 2, where I2 is the secondary current and RE2 is the, obviously it's RE only, so we can calculate that from the SC test. And cos theta 2 is the secondary power factor that will be given. That means, as we have discussed PF in the efficiency case, here also it's PF only that will be given. That means at what power factor, what is the value of voltage regulation, minus I2 XE2 sin theta 2, where XE2 is the XE only, and sin theta 2 can be calculated from cos theta 2. So I can provide voltage regulation for various power factors. So cos theta 2 is variable, that means we can give whatever power factor we can. That means at this power factor what is voltage regulation, at that power factor what is voltage regulation, how the voltage is regulated, that means how the voltage will be changing from no load to certain load. So this is the explanation for voltage regulation, and this is voltage regulation can be calculated for various power factors, and efficiency can be calculated for various power factors and also various loading conditions. And this is the complete explanation of OC and SC tests. So if you like this video, please like it. If you have any doubts in this video, please write in the comment box. And if I committed any mistake in this video, please let me know in the comment box, and try to share this video and kindly subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thank you. Thank you, one and all.